Hello everybody. Today I want us to have a look at how we can be able to configure static routing. And static routing basically is routing that occurs when the router uses a manually configured route. And these routes become fixed and basically they do not change even if the network has changed or even if the network has been reconfigured. So from the diagram that you can see here, I want us to assume that PC1 and PC2 are on one department and PC2 and MikroTik 2 are also on a different department, and these guys are both using different subnets. So we want a situation whereby if you are in a if you're using PC1, you are able to communicate to PC2. So let's get that configuration going. So let's log into MikroTik 1. And also let's have MikroTik 2 show up just on the side as well. So basically what we want to do is we want to assign our IPs for both MikroTik 1 and MikroTik 2. So as you can see, I have named this router 1. Let me also just quickly rename this as router 2. Okay, so basically what we want to do is we want to assign IPs for our LAN, and we also want to assign IPs for our WAN connection. And the WAN connection, this is what is going to be connecting the two MikroTiks together. So let's go ahead and do that. So from the diagram that you can see, I'm using GNS3 to do this. And for anybody who is also interested in knowing how to configure and use GNS Labs, I'm going to leave a link up here so that you can be able to go to that link and see how you can be able to install GNS. So what GNS does is their Ethernet ports are named from 0 to whatever number that you may pick. So Ether 0, basically this is Ether 1 on your MikroTik, and this is what is now giving me connectivity from GNS3 to my Winbox. That's why I'm able to connect to this virtual MikroTik through my Winbox. So what I have in this situation is I have Ether 2 connected to PC1 and I have Ether 3 connected to MikroTik 2. So what I now need to do is I need to configure the WAN for MikroTik 1. This is going to be Ether 3. So let's go ahead and give it an IP. So you need to come to IP addresses. Forget about this. This is just a management IP given to me by GNS3. So let's just assume that it's not there. So you need to come to IP, then you add. So let's use a one IP of, let's say, 102.100. Let's say .0.1/30. This is going to go to Ether 3 because Ether 3 is what connects us, it is what connects MikroTik 1 to MikroTik 2. So we are going to apply that, then we are going to click OK on that. So that is done. Let's do the same for router 2. So we are going to come to IP addresses. We are also going to give it an IP, let's say 102.100.0.2/30, and this is going to go to Ether 2. Apply that. Okay, that is going to go to Ether 2 because from the diagram you can see that the connection that we have is between Ether 3 and Ether 1 actually. Let me change that. The interface goes to Ether 1. Okay, so that's correct. So after doing that, for the static routing to work, we need to ensure that when you are on a router 1, you are able to ping router 2. So let's just try and see if we can be able to ping this IP over here from router 1. So what I need to do is just come to tools, ping, and let's go 102.100.0.2, click on start. So as you can see, router 1 is able to communicate to router 2. So let's get that out of the way. So the next thing that I want us to do is I want us to have an IP for our bridge or for our LAN. So in this case, we need to have an IP for, this is, as we say, this is Ether2. So we need to have an IP for Ether2, which is going to connect to our PC. So we need to come to router 1. Then you need to come to IP addresses. Let's add an IP, let's say 172.17.5.1/24. And now this goes to Ether2. Apply that. Okay. So we now have our IP for our LAN or our bridge, whichever way that you'll use to do it. So the next thing, we need also to do the same thing for router 2. So we need to come to IP, add, and let's see, we are putting the IP on Ether. So this is going to be Ether 2, which is now going to connect to PC 2. So let's pull back Winbox. So this, let's give it 10.10.10.1/24, and now this goes to Ether 2. Apply that. Okay. So the next thing that I want us to do is I want us to configure DHCP servers for both MikroTiks such that they are able now to lease out DHCP addresses to the respective PCs that are connected to them. So what I want us to do is, what you need to do, you come to IP, DHCP server, then DHCP setup. So for Ether, for router 1, the DHCP setup is going to go to Ether, let's see, it's going to go to Ether 2. Yeah. So the DHCP server interface, this goes to Ether 2. Next, DHCP address space, that looks okay. The gateway, that's okay. And addresses to be given out, this also looks okay. Next, and now the DHCP has been set up successfully for router 1. So let's do the same for router 2 IP, DHCP server, DHCP setup, and this also goes to Ether 2. Next, 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 maybe DNS, we could just even say 8.8.8. Next, next. And the DHCP server for router 2 has also been set successfully. So now let's go back to our diagram and see if our two PCs have been assigned IPs. So how do we log into our PCs? So just come to PC1, right click, and click on web console. So right now we are on PC1. So what we now need to do is ask PC1 to fetch a DHCP address from MikroTik 1. So how do we do that? You just type in DHCP. So let it fetch an IP, obtain an IP. Yeah, you can see it has now been given 172.17.5.254. You could also do show IP. So you can see the IP that has been given, the gateway, the DNS, and every other thing related to that. So let's do the same for PC2 as well. So you come to PC2, right click, web console, there it is, it's opened. So let's also do DHCP. Let it obtain an IP. Yeah, you can also see it has obtained its own IP 10.10.10.254. Let's also do show IP. Yeah, so there is all the information that it has been given from MikroTik 2. So what we want to do is we want to ensure that PC1 is able to communicate to PC2. So let's just take this IP 10.10.10.254 and see if we can ping that from PC1, sorry. So let's come to PC1. Let's try ping 10.10.10.254. I'm going to do a continuous ping and just let it run as we continue with the configurations. So you can see that the destination is unreachable. Let me just widen this. You can see that the destination is unreachable. So PC1 cannot communicate to PC2. So let's go to PC2 and see if PC2 is also able to communicate to PC1 or it's not. So the IP that we are supposed to target is 172.17.5.254. So PC2 ping 172.17.5.254. I'm also going to do a continuous ping for this. And as you can see, the destination is also unreachable. So now let's go ahead and configure our static routes on both MikroTiks. So we are going to start with MikroTik 1. So what we now need to do is you need to come to IP and routes. So this is now the routing table for router 1. And as you can see, there are already three routes that have been assigned, and these are routes that have already been assigned dynamically. So what we now want to do is we want to set up static routes. And we are going to use a bit of information of what is on router 1. So let's just have this address list appear here. So what we now need to do is you now need to come to routes and click on add. And now our destination address should be, because where are we trying to go to? We are trying to reach PC2. And for us to reach PC2, what is the IP range for that has been assigned to PC2? So the IP that has been assigned to PC2 from what we saw. Let me just open up MikroTik 2. Let me come to IP, DHCP server, and LIS. So this is supposed to be our destination, this subnet. So what we now need to do here is we need to input 10.10.10.0/24. That is going to be our DST address. And our gateway is now going to be our one address for router 2. That is going to be our gateway. And our gateway, that is 102.100.0.2. So we are going to input 102.100.0.2. And let's apply that. Yeah, and you can see the status is reachable. So click OK on that. So let's go back to our ping and see what is happening. So you can see that nothing has changed yet. So for starting routing, what happens is whatever you do to the first router, you also have to do the same to the second router. So let's do the same for the second router and create those routes as well. So we are going to have the IPs for router 1 displayed. Let me just get them. Yeah, there they are. So what I now need to do on router 2 is I need to come to IP routes. You can also see it has its own dynamic addresses that have been assigned. So let's now give it static routes. So I'm going to add a route, and now our destination for router 2 is going to be the LAN address of router 1, and that is 172.17.5. So our destination address is going to be 172.17.5.0/24, and our gateway is going to be the one assigned to router 1. So our gateway for this is going to be 102.100.0.1. So let's apply that, and you can also see the status is reachable, so we click OK on that as well. So let's go back to our ping and see what is happening. So you can see now PC2 is now able to ping PC1, and if we also go to PC1, let's just try do the same thing as well. Yeah, you can also see that PC1, the ping is going on successfully, and now PC1 is able to communicate to PC2. So guys, that is how you are able to do static routing. And for any other thing that you may need or require in regards to static routing, you can just go ahead and leave a comment down below. Any issue that you are experiencing while configuring this, or any other additional information that you might need, which may help you in your network. So guys, that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like, comment, and share the video so that others can also be able to see what we are doing here. So thank you, and bye bye.